Hey yo everybody, Johnny5 Alive here, and it's an exciting time for Planet Coaster. The winter update is upon us. This is amazing. So, there's a lot to go over. Yeah, I was feeling a little bit sick lately. I had a trouble sleeping, only got like 2 or 3 hours sleep. Woke up, got a coffee, and then boom, I saw the tweet. Here we are. So I can cover this first thing this morning. It's gonna take me a while to make this video, but hopefully you guys are ready for this because we have a lot to go over. So get yourself comfortable, get a coffee, do what you gotta do. Let's get ready to review this winter update. So stay tuned and let's check it out. Alright, if you guys do like this video, please be sure to smash that like button. And if you're new to this channel, be sure to subscribe. I do all Planet Coaster news, videos, guides, tutorials, you name it. It's here on Channel 5 Gaming. And let me know what you guys think of this winter update down in the comments below. Alright, let's get into this. I have to bring up the patch notes here. Now, one thing they forgot to do here, at least I didn't see, is the patch number. I think it's supposed to be patch 1.02, or they're just calling it Winter Update. I don't know. However, it's only been 4 weeks since this game has launched, I believe. The second week after this game came out, there was a pretty huge update, a quite necessary update, in my opinion. But this here, the Winter Update, is more than just an update. It's a freaking expansion pack. So if you were on the... Oh, yeah! Planet Coaster King is freaking out in the background. So if you were on the fence about getting this game before, now is the time to do so because this is huge. We're gonna actually go through these options in game, but I do want to go through and just show you guys how crazy these patch notes are. So there's new management features. They have added reputation, ride decay, and we're gonna talk more about this in game. They've added new notifications, park management system, new sensibility color for open, close, and close rides. They added a workload indicator. Oh my god, there's just so much good stuff here. We gotta look at it in game though. New rides. They added a collider, a bump and derby. We got a sleigh ride, iron horse, new scenarios, new location, the Arctic, sandbox mode with new challenge mode, new scenery, festive theme, gingerbread wall set, icing decorations, 140 new scenery pieces, Christmas trees, baubles, candles, sweets, snowmen, and gifts and presents. This is crazy. 7 new shops and signs. We're gonna look at these more in game. New camera changes, new coasters for the blueprints. And then there's just a whole bunch of fixes and improvements, ride improvements, guest improvements, staff improvements, UI improvements, localization and text improvements, scenery improvements, audio, stability. For those of you who are on lower end machines, this is great. One of the things here is improved performance, reviewed model LODs to ensure optimal rendering and low LOD assets. This is great. This means things will pop out earlier and they've reviewed and gone over a lot of the models to make sure that they do that. That way, when you're zooming out of your park, it's giving you a better performance overall. Great for those massive parks. So a lot of really good stuff here. Now, I'm gonna have to go through this. It's gonna be quite an editing process getting this trimmed down for you guys, but we're gonna figure it out. Before we get into anything, I believe they've added new facial hair or something. So how do we look at this? They said they added some chops there and this. Awesome. So that's one new thing. Hey, okay, I thought it saved it. And then we go into career mode. They've added in Festive King Coasters Crackers. This is amazing. The first level is Festive Funlands. It's time to unwrap our plans for a festive theme park in this jolly location. Just remember that your cash is a loan, not a gift. Spruce up your winter wonderland with seasonal scenery and draw in the merry crowds from far around. Cavernous Coasters. An exotic grotto has been discovered and restricted planning permissions grants you the opportunity to create a unique park in this hollowed out habitat. Building above the cavern is strictly prohibited and guest numbers are limited, so you need to conquer the depths to ensure this venture is a success. This one looks cool. It reminds me of a good golly Miss Molly type scenario. I might just have to go crazy on this one. And then the last one, I think one of the devs was saying in yesterday's stream that this was his favorite, Back from the Brink, because it reminded him of your traditional trope style parks from like the old school game. times. You'll need to be at the top of your game for this one. The former owners have abandoned this park and left it in a real mess. Negative cash reserves, a huge loan to pay off, a ludicrous layout, and some serious inefficient amusement rides. If you can turn this around, it'll be a miracle. And the dev was saying he could only get bronze on this. So this is awesome to see more challenge modes added in, or should I say career mode, with some cool innovative ideas. This is something that I was wishing for in my review, and here it is. So we have new content to look at, but before we do that, we're gonna jump into this scenario and just take a look at it, because they said that they added in new wall sets and this map looks like it's using them. So it's a great time to just kind of jump in and take a look at things. Festive Funlands. Oh wow, look at this, it's on a hilltop. Oh, this is beautiful. So we're also getting our first look at the new terrain, which is the biome, I should say, which is the Alpines. I love it. It was just snowing in Vancouver here for the last 3 or 4 days. So, and I just love playing snowy games in December for some reason. Just so good. All right, look at this. We've got lollipops. We've got gingerbread houses. And from my understanding, oh, they're locked. Darn it. Anyways, what I was going to say is, from my understanding, these are all made up of pieces. So they're just like your traditional wall sets. So each one of these little gumdrops are placed onto a ginger wall. The icing's been added in. And this is amazing. And what's really good about this is these little icing sticks, they're going to really be useful in combination with the basic shapes that we've been playing with all along. Same with these little gummy drops. Now we have smaller circles, we have smaller lines, and we can use these to our advantage while building our crazy little thingies. This is awesome. Look at this. I love all this candy. You got Smarties, whatever these things are, Jujubes. They're like the sugar-coated Jujubes. And we got the little sour candies. Oh, look at these. They're like little Twix bars. Little heart cookie thingies. Do they have the German cookies? Oh, they got, what are these? I never liked those. That's why I don't remember what the name of them are. Oh well. I know you, some of you guys are screaming at your monitor. Candy corn. Yeah. Oh, these are amazing. Caramel, what are they, Werther's or whatever? They've got some, oh, this is good. Right here. What is that? Waffle. So I've seen people making waffle cone ice cream. Now we actually have a waffle texture to make our waffle cone ice cream. Oh my goodness. We have little cookies with the little kiss drop thingies. What are those called? Icing something? Icing tips? Something like that. These chocolates. I was never a fan of these chocolates. They tasted funny to me. But they look really yummy. Anything new here? Ooh, this is like my favorite kind of German cookie. Oh, if the white ones, and it has like ginger bread in the inside. Oh my God, they're so good. I forgot what they're called. How dare I? And we got cookies on top. Oh my God, cookie sticks. Oh, I want to eat this. This is so good. Okay, we got a little church over here with some more unique cookies. Oh, these cookies with the little strawberry centers. Mmm, I love those. Oh my God. Oh, we got the different kinds of, what are they, marshmallows? Oh, marshmallows, the little snowman thingies. Oh, this is so good. Really, like I want to eat it. Oh, look at these little beans. Candy beans? Jelly beans. I'm silly. They're jelly beans, candy beans. Same thing, right? Icicle frosting. Oh. And we're probably going to be able to recolor them. Oh, candy cane spirals. See, now these are really good to go with the basic shapes. We can use these little jelly beans for smiley faces. And we can use these little things as eyes. Like, this gives me a lot of ideas for our basic shape creations. I love it. Oh, we have pretzels. Oh, they need to add a pretzel shop now. Oh my god. Pretzel shop. Please add that in the future. I love those giant pretzels. So yummy. Okay, we gotta set the time of day here. Alright, now we can see things a little clearer. Oh, the little squigglies. Oh, that's a... that's a deckle? Huh. Oh. Look at this. More little deckle things? It's a planet coaster cookie. Alright, so we're starting to see a lot of similarities here. I think we've gotten through most of the candy. I'm assuming that they went all out and used all the new candy sets on these houses, which is why I wanted to look at this first. Oh, we didn't see these yet. Oh, those look delicious. Oh, they're like those Ferrero Rochers, sort of. Oh man, those look good. Oh, this is amazing. Oh, look, it's a gingerbread car. Oh, that makes me so happy. Oh, he broke. Aw, poor guy. He's still happy, though. Oh, and she's freaking out. He's like, oh, she broke. Someone ran him over. Oh, that's what happened. I'm silly. The car ran him over. And she's freaking out. And they're just standing by smiling. You sadistic cookies. Oh, look at these. Oh, they're like firework candles. Yes, I realize there's a big tree beside me. I'm saving the best for last. Oh, look at his little hat. These crazy little Cookie Land people. Oh my god. It looks so good. Alright, let's look at this tree. Oh, look at him. Santa on top. Oh, this is so good. It's made out of just a bunch of cookies. With the, what are they called? Icing drops. Oh, wow. Look at these cookies. It's got the coconut sprinkles on it. That's an amazing little tree there. Peppermint spiraling around it. Oh my god. Oh, you can make little doorways. Oh, and this heart thingy. There's so many details that just keep popping up. We got Christmas tree gingerbreads. Am I missing anything? Oh, look at this one. Overhang. Oh, there's candy canes. Oh, dear god. Oh, look at the Smarties. Ooh. Chocolate dipped on one side. Well, well, well. Oh, look, that's another cookie we missed. This guy here. Oh, what are these called? See, when it was pushed in, it reminded me of a different kind of cookie, but now that I could see it, Chef Ramsay loves these things. I don't remember what they're called. I've actually never had one, I don't think. The one I was thinking of is just the top. They're like little spongy German cookies. The white glaze, ginger on the inside. If anyone knows the name of that, put it down in the comments below. You will make my day if you know what German cookie I'm speaking of. Ah, look at this. Okay, well, this is the little ginger town, gingerbread town. I wonder if you can actually get a path coming up here or a train station coming up here. And then just build around here and get some shops and stuff in here. Well, you know what? The items are locked. This map might be better in challenge mode, so you can actually put shops and stuff inside of these. Oh, this is awesome. Okay, so obviously there's going to be a lot of locked things. So we're going to just look at the next scenario now. And then we're going to end up going into sandbox mode to look at all the new content. And next, we're going to look at cavernous coasters. Let's take a look at this. So they said there's a height restriction, so I'm assuming you can't build up here. Oh my god, look at this map. You have to build in the grotto. But it does remind me of Good Golly Miss Molly. You're going to have these paths coming down here on the edges. And I'm hoping you can dig holes through things. Is there a better way to light this? We're gonna have to literally take a torch in here, I think. It does seem like it goes inward somewhere. Maybe not too much. Uh-oh, Camera's getting stuck. Alright, so you can go in there. You're gonna have to light it up. Oh, but then there's a border here. So maybe not. Alright, let's look at the grotto itself. This is really nice. This is... Oh, look at this spiraling staircase. Oh, wow. Wow, wow, wow. Now, this map is very cool. I had to switch to offline mode so my Steam people don't bug me. Alright, so it seems like you're going to need a lot of light before you can really get started, because there's these caverns and whatnot. And I'm hoping... Oh, crap. No, you can't edit the terrain. That makes things a little less interesting, because I wanted to make more canyons so I could run a coaster through the cliffs. Nonetheless, that is okay. I think this will be a great challenge mode map. I would love to have some rides around the outside in challenge mode, dropping into the grotto. I can see myself having fun on this. Awesome. All right, let's look at the next scenario. All right, the next scenario we're going to be looking at is Back from the Brink. It's apparently really difficult. So this is a rundown park, and it's apparently got a bad layout. It's got a bad bunch of things wrong with it. How big's the map that we're dealing with here? Very big. Very big. I love this little lake here. You can have like a bridge going across it. Maybe build like a little dock with a Ferris wheel. Make like this little GTA pier. A little fishing dock. Little workshop here. Broken down train. This is going to be a great map to have trains and stuff, transport rides. Nice and big. It's a little bit flat, but that's okay. The pathing is atrocious, so you're going to have to rethink the pathing system here. Interesting. So not bad, and then they got some little town thingies. Oh my god, atrocious pathing again. Interesting. What is this? Oh, it's a Speed. The Speed 500 coaster. Oh, that's not a... I guess it's a pretty crappy coaster. Probably just delete it, make a better one. Interesting. There's like a Kraken statue. It's great. King of the Lake. Well, not anymore. You guys went and plucked him. Due to funding. Okay, this is awesome. Everything's like incomplete, and it's just the crappiest little theme park. But there's a lot of potential here. A lot of potential. Cool. So apparently there's a new challenge mode as well. So there's the Arctic. Now, one thing I'm curious to know is if they've made it so you can pick a custom map and choose the difficulty. Darn it, I don't have any custom maps. We're gonna have to check that out another time, but I really hope you could choose the difficulty on a custom map now, because before it was only choose harder mode from here. I really hope you could do a challenge mode, or I mean a custom map in challenge mode. So the Arctic looks amazing. I'm so excited for this. We're gonna go into sandbox mode and check out the new Arctic map. So here we are. This is beautiful. Nice and big. Oh, looks so good. The detail. Woo! Nice normal maps. Alright, let's kick things off with the new rides. First of all, we have, what is this called? The Bumpin' Derby. Let's turn the volume up a bit. Hopefully you guys can hear that a little bit. Let's take a look at this thing at nighttime. Nice retro lights. Very cool. I can't wait to watch these people bump into each other. Now, fun little story. I guess it's not a fun story. It's a terrifying story. When I was a kid and I went on the bumper cars, some guy came over to help me, and I accidentally ran him over. I ran his foot over. Kind of sucked for him. I felt really bad, and I still remember it to this day. But I was like 5 years old, and I still remember it. I felt bad. He was probably all right. He didn't. I don't think he needed to go to medical. But I did crush his foot. He should have probably turned the ride off. Anyways, next ride is... Where is she? He. Alright, this is the Collider, and I love this thing because I have this in my local theme park at the P&E. It's called the Enterprise. And this, it's exactly the way it is in the P&E. This is amazing. This is so good. Let's speed it up. It's supposed to go vertical. Yeah! Oh, I love this thing. Sounds like a freaking Star Wars vehicle. Oh, that is so good. I love it. I'm curious to see what kind of ride skins people come up for this. Yeah, this is gonna be amazing. Good times. So they've added in like 10 new coasters. So the Frenzy, this is a new coaster. Look at this monstrosity. Now we're not gonna ride all these coasters. I'll let you guys have that fun because there's just too many of them. We're just gonna take a quick look at them. This is the Harbinger. This is a new one. Ooh, it's a hybrid coaster. Very cool. This is the Impulse. Wow, look at this thing. This is huge. Wow, that takes up like a third of the park. Very cool. This is the Lycanthrope. Did I say that right? I guess it's like a werewolf. That's cool. We have the Rebel, which is a mine train cart. Really good to see that they've added in more coaster blueprints. This is amazing. Red Steel. This looks like another hybrid coaster. Ooh, ooh, ooh. And this is another one of the new features. They've added in catwalks. Some of the coasters have stairs as well. They've added like stair catwalks. Awesome. This is the Screamer. It's your traditional corkscrew coaster. Really nice. Lots of loops. Fantastic. We have the Hunt, which is a Pioneer coaster, the little birdie. Very simple, but fun. Kiddie ride. Trailblazer Athon. Cool. This is Twister Enigma coaster. Wow. It's a pretty cool corkscrew. And the last one is the Whirlwind, and it's the little spinny cart thing. I love this coaster. And there's the little catwalks on there. I think those are new. So if they get stuck there, I guess, I don't know, people can get them off. I don't know how that works. Very interesting. And here we go again. We got a new look at the new feature, which is the catwalks. There's a staircase going up the side. Very cool. Love these little catwalks. Awesome. So that's 11 new coaster blueprints. Oh, guys, how could I forget? How could I forget? There's two more rides that I forgot about. There's the Iron Horse. It's a transport ride. Look at this thing. Oh, so good. That's amazing. So we have a new transport ride. And there's a new track ride, the Sleigh. Look at this. Perfect for the Winter Wonderland theme. That's amazing. So we have another scenery ride and another transport ride. Thank you, Frontier. So good. So good. I might have to clip this part back so this whole video is kind of organized. Alright guys, next up we gotta look at the new shops. And then we're gonna go over the blueprints again. 7 new shops. Alright, let's get a good look at these new shops. Did I put down 7? No, there's 8 because there's another one that has improvements. So, first up, Cosmic Cow Ice Cream. That doesn't look too delicious. In the trays? That doesn't look yummy. Nonetheless, the waffle cones look amazing. Little balls. We have sauce back here. Oh, yummy, yum, yum. The signs look great. Oh, I'm so excited about this one. And if you guys see my Workshop Wednesday video, the last one I did, some guy made a perfect ice cream shop. So this is going to go really well in there. I'm excited to make some ice cream shops. And in my sci-fi series, I'm doing a large, medium, and small sci-fi shop of every kind. And now I have a whole bunch of homework to do because we have 7 new shops. Next up, we have the Gulpy Soda. And now this is awesome. I'm really glad they added this in. They have a little orange logo, I guess. And so it's Gulpy Pop. Gulpy Soda. Awesome. Now we have 3 Gulpy shops. Then we have Hats Fantastic. I guess you can't see it here, but maybe in the stats it'll show. They've added an elf hat, a reindeer hat. Yes, an elf hat and a reindeer hat. Now, we might have to move this. Okay, I just opened up those 2 rides, and I want to see if anyone buys these hats. We're actually going to make all the hats free. And while we're at it, look at this new feature, everybody. Use the same prices and extras for all shops of this type. Boom. Now if we go over to this Hats Fantastic shop, it has the same price. Amazing synchronized shops. So here come the people. We have to fast forward this. Hopefully somebody buys an elf hat. Hold on. Can we select what hats? I thought you were able to choose what hats they sell. Because in the summertime, I'm not exactly going to want elf and reindeer hats. But that's okay. Let's see if anybody buys a hat. I'm giving them away for free, and nobody's going to get one. Are you kidding me? They're free. Come on, people. Somebody, please, get a hat. See, now, this is one of the things they said they improved in the patch notes here. It says that they improved people's desires to go get souvenirs. And I did this before with the Looney Balloons when I was testing my Wally shop. I literally sat on fast forward mode for, 5 minutes before somebody actually went and took a free balloon. So these hats are free and nobody is taking one. They looked at it. Come on. They're free. They're getting hats. Somebody get a reindeer hat. They're getting hats. Oh, he got the reindeer hat. We gotta pause this. Oh, look at this. It has a reindeer nose. And the kid got the elf hat. That's got fat elf ears. Oh, how cute. We got the cowgirl. Oh, it's got reindeer ears. I didn't notice that. Oh, that's so good. Ugh. That was a lot of work just to get someone to get a hat. A free hat. All these people, and no one wanted a free hat. And now we can see the bumper cars in action. Look how much fun they're having. Oh! Bash them! Yeah! Oh! Look how angry this guy looks. Yeah, let's get these kids. Arrgh. Here we go. Nope. Dodged. Oh! Look at that guy. He's pro. Oh! She's waving at her friend over there. That's so cute. Alright, I've had enough fun with that. That's amazing. Why is no one riding this thing? Load up! Yeah! Oh, this brings back so many memories. Woo! Alright, awesome. Alright, back to the shop stalls. So, this guy, we got the donuts. This is amazing. Because look what I've been melding in my blueprints. Where is it? So I made a vanilla dipped sprinkled donut. Oops. A chocolate sprinkled donut. I've made a giant donut. I made the big ones at first, and I was like, these are way too big. So I made the mini ones. But now looking at the way that they do their donuts, I want to eat it. It looks so good. The way they do their donuts, they have pink with white sprinkles. And then they also have like a... They also have like a caramel with nuts. But yeah, they have pink with white sprinkles and chocolate with white sprinkles. So I may have to change my donuts to match those. And I will do that. Maybe I'll make a box of donuts. I love this. And what's this one called? Missy Good. Missy Good's donut. So she has. They have this little girl. I might have to make her out of the shapes. I might just have to do that. I'll make a Missy Good's donut shop. Oh boy, I'm excited. All right, next up we have the Pip Shot juice. So these are the healthy drinks. Healthy choices. You got juice boxes here. Pip Shot. And it's like a little bag or something. A bag of juice. Drink for life. Pip Shot juice. Love it. And then we have the Pip Shot smoothies. Fresh fruit smoothies. I love it. Looks great. And then we have Pip Shot water. And kind of boring, but everybody needs water. Overpriced water from the park. So I'm going to have to make a Pip Shot series now on my channel. And this guy, oh goodness. Pizza. This pizza texture looks horrendous. I don't want to eat that pizza. It's like black. I guess those are olives. Still, I don't like me any olives on my pizza. Oh well, they should have just had a traditional pepperoni. Pizza pen. That's what this one is. So they have like a pizza bandit. Pretty cool. I like the kind of mask. Oh wait, I was looking at this wrong. So he's happy. See, it depends on which way you look at it. See, I was looking at it like these are the two eyes. Like he's a sad piece of pizza. But if you look at it this way, he's actually a happy piece of pizza. That's hilarious. I thought he was so sad. Okay, I was looking at it wrong. So, that's interesting. I might have to make the pizza shape out of basic shapes and then do some shops. So, that's 7 new shops with Hats Fantastic improvements. 2 new hats there. This is crazy. This video, my recording's already 43 minutes and I'm probably nowhere near done. Guys, this dawned on me in the editing process. I forgot to check for new signs. So they added in this Cosmic Cow ice cream sign. There's this ice cream sign. There's all the awnings, the Missy Good donut awning, the Pip Shot. I guess that's the smoothie. Or this is the smoothie. That's the juice. This is the water. Pizza pen. It's very reminiscent of the Hot Dog Squad. And then, I don't know if that one's new. I put it down anyways. Here's the gulpy soda. They've added in some donut. And then I guess this is the neon version. Some ice cream cones. Some pizza. Very cool. Then some, what is this? The smoothies. The water. New Cosmic Cow. It's pretty much the same as the old, but I think it's just pink now. Pink background. Ice cream. Ice cream. They went all out for the Cosmic Cow ice cream. And that's it. I feel like they're missing some stuff. Because there should be more signs like this. And I feel like there needs to be more signs like this for the other. Like, I would appreciate like a big Missy Good's donut sign would be perfect. Unless I missed it. But that feels like it. And if we look at the shop stalls, Missy Good's Donuts, for example, has this little girl on the inside. So a sign like that would have been nice. A bigger sign that says, like, Missy Good's and has her in between. I mean, I might be missing it, but I looked through it all. And maybe some more signs for Pip Shot would have been nice. Some more, because they have a whole series. It's just as big as Gulpy now. but they don't really have any of the memorabilia to go along with it, which kind of makes it somewhat disappointing. Makes me feel like a sad pizza. Anyways, it's still good, still great. All right, back to whatever I was talking about last. Shops and facilities, there's going to be new blueprints, I believe. So we have our new entrances. There's all sorts of new blueprints in here. We have a Gulpy shop. So these are some of the ones that we saw in that scenario. Interesting. So that's a Cosmic Cow. What is this? It's a double-sided shop. Oh my god, they have nutcrackers. That's amazing. There's so many shops, it's ridiculous. Yeah, like I was saying, guys, this is like an expansion pack. That's not new. This is certainly like an expansion pack. Okay, so that's all the new shops. Is there any new blueprints? Very cool. Some candy cane clusters. Oh, a Christmas tree with presents. Oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy. A candy Christmas tree. Oh my god, look at this. That is adorable. Choo-choo. Oh, so cute. Oh, I love them. They're like posing for a selfie. I gotta put like a little selfie cam in her hand. Oh, look at this one. They're like dueling. Draw! Oh! Oh, there's a little happy family. We built a snowman! Oh. Oh my god. Carolers. Wait, I think that was in the patch notes. I think they said carolers are in the game. Aw, this guy's left out. They poured water on him. Okay, this is hilarious. Oh, look at that stack of presents. Look at that stack of presents. Okay, seems like that's all the new scenery. What about buildings? We have some new buildings, and these are, again, from the scenario. These are all the ones we looked at in the scenario. Yes, they are indeed. Oh, I didn't see this one though. It's like a well. They should have actually made a well. Oh, this one's cute. I think we saw that one though. There's like a little church. There's wreaths. Very cool. So now we're gonna have to, do they have like a new way to sort this? Scenery, custom, more, scenery, theme, festive. Oh, you guys ready for this? I mean, look at all this festive stuff. We have snow of all sorts. I mean, should I go through all this? I mean, you can see it in the icons. There's just a bajillion ornaments. Okay, I get it. Yeah, there's a lot of ornaments. Ooh, Christmas tree that you can decorate. Oh, look at that one, red ribbons. What's this? Bonbon? Candy canes. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. Tiny candy canes. Those disgusting candies, the corn thingies. Oh, lollipops. Chocolate cups. Oh, delicious. Now they should have added in a candy shop. I mean, they do have the ice cream, but a candy shop would have been amazing. Look at all this stuff. So we did see most of this, so I don't really need to show it again. We got bells. That's something I haven't seen. Bows. Oh, those are going to be so good. Lights. Lots of different lights in different sizes and shapes. And we can recolor them. I'm assuming we can recolor all of these things. Like the bow. Yes, we can. Very good. Awesome. Lots of gingerbread. Oh, it's a gingerbread reindeer. The presents are amazing. We've seen just a big stack of them. So we know there's a whole bunch of presents. All right. And then there's these little marshmallow faces. Then you can actually build a snowman. There's like one with a pre-made head on it. And you could put a carrot. Oh, that's awesome. And there's this guy. Oh no, somebody buried him. Oh, there's like hats and stuff. Oh, this is gonna be great for the Hats Fantastic shops. Oh, earphones. This is great. There's tons of hats. This is great. I love it. Oh, and you could color the elfin hat, I bet. Yes, sir. Perfect. Oh, there's like the bandit. So now you can actually make a bandit. This is great for Wild West stuff. Come up with some cool ideas with that. You get it. And there's a pipe, a snow shovel. So there's a lot of hidden stuff that we didn't get a look at in that scenario. More ornaments and stuff. Beep. Oh, it plays the theme song. And then there's the waffle stuff. So now you can actually make a waffle cone ice cream. Oh, that's great. This is too much, guys. So that's all the new scenery pieces. Is there any new building sets? Oh, I'm sure there is. Festive. Oh, boy, oh boy. We have looked at so much stuff. So there's like the chimney. There's the different circular gingerbread. So it's all just gingerbread building sets. We have hearts. Icing. All sorts of icing shapes. Now these icing shapes are going to be great to go mixed in with the basic shapes that we're used to using. Because now we can get those like fine little details in. And I'm assuming we can recolor these icings, right? So now we can actually get little details on certain things that we're building in our basic shapes. So I can see a lot of people using these in mixture with their basic shapes to create some really cool stuff. Like even these could be little arms and different things. So we have windows and more ginger shapes. So yeah, you guys get it. There's a ton of different ginger shapes of all sorts of sizes and variations. Everything that you could need to make a gingerbread house. I'm not as interested in the gingerbread houses. Gingerbread houses all look the same. They all look like gingerbread houses. And they got plenty of them right here. I think it's cool, but I'm not going to be making a gingerbread theme park any day soon. I think it's nice to have a little section of it, but I don't think I'm going to be going crazy with the gingerbread pieces. But they're all there. And then there's like wreaths. These are really good for lining. And then the icicles or the icing. I could see myself using these, making like a Yeti cave. But yeah, I would definitely have a gingerbread like town, but I don't maybe build a couple gingerbread houses and be done with it because there's so many right here already. It's a cool set though. I definitely appreciate the effort gone into it and I love it. I think it's amazing. I just don't think I'll be personally spending a whole lot of time with the gingerbread pieces. I do love it all though. It's all amazing. I love it. I love it. And they also said they added in new, I think they said colorable flower beds. Yes. So you can color some plants now. Can we color all the old ones? No. Viola flowers. So they added in a few new flower types, which you can recolor. I think it's just those two, to be honest. But nonetheless, that's awesome. I love the idea of coloring them. So I'll probably be using these two new ones a lot. Amazing. Amazing. Oh boy, and here we go. There's another staff member, Festive King Coaster. And you can spam place them now, one after another. So you don't have to keep going back into the menu. Here they come. Look how good they look. Squeaky, squeaky, squeaky. Amazing. Oh god, look at this traffic jam. It's like our park's trying to fill up based on the items we've placed down, but this is all we let them explore. All right, guys, so there's a huge changes in the park management settings, and this is absolutely amazing. So there's a new all staff button. This is new. And what's really cool about this whole section now, this is something I talked about in my day one review that this game really lacked, was more micromanagement here. And now what we can do is we can increase the training of our staff right from this menu. We can increase their pay rate right from this menu. And then there's like the work roster if we create a new work roster. So say we want them to walk around this area only and we save that as bumper cars. Now we have the bumper cars area. Now we could take one of those King Coaster guys that we just hired and we can assign them to the bumper cars area just like that. And we can also fire them right from here. And they also says their workload. So if their workload is very high, you might want to up their training. Or like if it's a coffee shop and it has like a super high workload, you might want to consider adding in another coffee shop nearby. and that would help lower their workload. And I think this is fantastic for the behind the scenes kind of park management stuff, knowing, you know, this guy's not very busy, so maybe like we have too much in that area. Like they're bored. There's not enough people going there. There's not enough traffic. How do we fix this problem? These numbers, this information really adds a lot more replayability and interest to the game to me. I think they changed some of the guest thoughts. I don't know exactly what it was. They added some improvements there. Attractions and shops. So they've added some cool stuff here, guys. This is amazing. So now the shops say, or the rides rather, say how long they've been open for, and it tells you a prestige. Let me pull up my notes. Okay, so ride prestige used to be a hidden value running in the background. They now show us this value. What is ride prestige? It is appeal and value of a ride to the guests. It increases by improving scenery or by improving the ride experience. So for example, on rides, you can increase the amount of rotations, you can increase the length of the ride, you can increase how fast it goes. And by doing all those different things, it's going to help increase your prestige. And then also by increasing the scenery around it, increases your prestige. Now this is a huge, huge addition to the game right now, because instead of just plopping down your rides and being like, I think my park is done, you're going, oh look, I don't have 5 stars on all these rides. So now you're going into all your rides and going, let's make sure these are all 5-starred. And once you have 5-star prestige on all your rides, then it's time to move on. If you don't have 5 stars, you haven't done a good enough job decorating it, and then it'll actually force you to go in and change the amount of things that it does. Clockwise loop, ground clockwise loop high, and you could just go in here and increase all these. And now, like before, I was looking at this and I was like, yeah, well, why would I ever change that? I'll just leave it the way it is. Well, this is why you would change it, to increase its prestige. People want to go on this because it does more than it normally does. People want to go on this because it has more scenery than the average ride does. They've also added in ride decay. I don't know where this is shown. Don't know where it's shown. So I don't know if it's behind the scenes or not. They haven't added a tooltip here for ride decay, but it does say it in the patch notes. So it says something about ride decay. So ride decay is when the ride diminishes and wears and tears. And you can also go in and request a refurbishment, which is going to help the decay come back. So this is the wear and tear. I'm assuming this is the ride decay, and this is going to affect your prestige. So if the ride is very old and rickety, the prestige is also going to go down. So keep an eye on your decay and make sure you request refurbishments once in a while. And what's cool here is they also added a ride reputation somewhere. Yeah, they said that they added in a ride reputation, and I don't know why I'm not seeing it here. Well, if you guys find the ride reputation, put it down in the comments below for me. They said the ride reputation adds nostalgia factor into rides. So, for example, a new ride will have a high reputation because it's brand new and people want to go on it. And an old ride will start losing reputation. However, once it becomes super old, it's like a classic. So it has a nostalgia factor, and it may gain, like if you have a 10-year-old Ferris wheel in your park, people might want to go on it just for like the nostalgia factor. So the reputation may go up. Now I'm really wishing I knew exactly where that was, but they've added in all sorts of information here, and I love this. This prestige thing adds so much more gameplay, just this alone, because now I'm thinking to myself, well, this bump and derby, it sucks. It's a 1 prestige. I want to try and get this thing. I want to get all my rides to 5 stars. And that's a whole new element to the game. That's a game in itself. They needed this. It's so good. So yeah, this whole new improved menu system is fantastic. Oh, they've added in something for coasters. Let's do a custom one. Let's just put this guy down. So if we start building our coaster, what's cool is you can see it has a number here, 20 meters. And then if we're turning it, oh, let's drop it down. We're gonna switch to a regular track. If we're turning it, it says the angle of which you're turning it, 22.5 degrees, 45 degrees, 67 degrees. That is amazing. It's so good. Minus 22 degrees slope, 45 degrees slope. So we could see it's a 45 degree slope down, and we had a 45 degrees sideways. So now you get a good understanding of how your slopes are reacting. which is absolutely amazing. And as I mentioned, they've added these new catwalks to the coasters. So there's like little staircases and stuff. Is this the carolers? They're not really caroling. I guess you could add some speakers next to them. They look amazing though. I kind of wish they were singing though. I was really pumped up for this. I wanted to hear a little singing the Planet Coaster song. Oh well, that's cute nonetheless. Oh, I saw what I wrote about the guest thoughts. They added guest thoughts for ride decay. That's something in there. So if a ride is really old, guests might start thinking about that. Like, this ride is too old for me. And that's when you might want to start refurbishing it. Oh, they've also added in quick save, quick load. So let me try this. Save park. If I hit F5, F8, it doesn't work. Oh, it's F9. Okay, so all they did was reduce one menu. I wish it was a quick save, quick load. So it still brings up the menu. It just skips the main menu. Not exactly what I wanted, but it's an improvement. Then they've said that they've added in a tutorial, advanced simulations tutorial in the main menu somewhere. And oh boy, I think we did it, guys. I think we made it through all the new stuff. I'm sure I missed some small thing somewhere along the line. There's so many new features, so many new improvements. This is absolutely amazing. And between all the new shop stalls types, I have all my work to do. The collider, all this stuff. I'd have to say my favorite improvement is the prestige. Absolutely amazing, because it gives you something to work towards while you're playing the game. You really want to try and 5-star all your rides. And then when you do that, you therefore then have a really impressive park. If I open up your park and I see low prestige on all your rides, I'm going to be a lot less impressed. And if I see 5-star on all your rides, I will be very impressed. So it really adds a whole new gameplay element to the game. And that's probably my favorite feature. However, my second favorite feature in terms of, or my, I guess my, my other favorite feature in terms of creativity is definitely going to be the shops, because I'm the shop guy. I like making shops on the blueprints and on the Steam Workshop. So that's awesome. And I do like the new transport and kitty ride. Those are great. These are also great. I love this ride because I have one in my local park. Everything about this. It's an expansion pack. The gingerbread. I mean, this is all amazing stuff. There's so much to do and so much to look at now. This is really, guys, this is an expansion pack, not a winter update. This is so good. And that's everything, guys. Hopefully I didn't miss anything. If I did, let me know down in the comments below. But my recording's an hour and 13 minutes. Hopefully we can chop that down for you guys to something smaller. Anyways, if you guys like this video, please be sure to smash that like button, subscribe for more Planet Coaster news and videos, and let me know what you guys think of this winter update down in the comments below. All right, everybody, happy holidays, happy winter update. I will see you in the next video.